We traveled everywhere. I've never worked harder than that in my life. That was the hardest I've ever worked.
That was longtime composer, producer, and jazz performer Bobby Watson, just one of the legendary musicians interviewed for a recent project sponsored by the Jazz Arts Group of Columbus. The group traveled the nation to find America's best musicians and share their findings with students. And we are joined this morning by three musicians who worked on this project: Ohio State alums John Lampley there on the end, Dan White here on this end, and Chris Ott from the band The Dan White Sextet. Guys, thanks for being with us this morning.
Absolutely. Thank you for having us.
First, let's start with you. Tell us where this project all got started.
Yeah, well, we started about 6 months ago. We were teaching artists with Jazz Arts Group, and basically we were trying to come up with an idea to try and engage students and a larger audience with the music that we're making. So out of that, we kind of started thinking about the larger picture of things and trying to tell a story. And so out of that, we kind of thought about, well, why don't we try and look back and try and listen first before writing music? So we decided to go to about 9 cities and try and listen and talk to musicians of older generations about their experiences and their stories, and then try and say it through our perspective as younger musicians.
That is just fantastic. Kristen, tell me what that experience was like, meeting some of these greats.
It was pretty amazing. I mean, it was a little tough just to make the calls to, you know, line up the interviews to meet these people, but once we got in the door, you know, we came in as not really knowing them, and a lot of times when we left, we were giving them a hug, we were
right.
giving them our CD, they were giving us their CD, and so it was really great to make those connections and, you know, an instant connection between musicians. We didn't have to play for each other, but we were, you know, on the same ground, like, instantly.
Sure. Really, I'm sure, nice. That was a little bit surreal, though.
Yeah.
John, tell me about then what that experience was like and how you brought that back and how it changed your perspective as you're going into schools here in Central Ohio.
Absolutely. Well, you know, going and talking to all of these different people really opened our eyes to the way, you know, that things were back when they were making music. And what was unbelievable is that, you know, we were in cities like, you know, New Orleans and Kansas City, so that weren't necessarily close to each other. But everybody was saying the same sort of things. You know, there were about, you know, 3 or 4 main themes that everybody would kind of come back to. And so when we came back here to Columbus and started, you know, writing music based on these stories and working with students, we just really tried to make those points hit home with them once we kind of came back to this area.
Definitely. Yeah. And Dan, how did you choose the musicians that you set out to interview?
Well, a lot of it was the ones that would have us.
Okay.
I mean, the time frame for the project was really, really short. We released a CD, our last CD called Play, this past August, and about 3 weeks later, you know, Cardinal Health, you know, gave us a grant to do this project, and we went, and about 3 weeks after we released that, we were on the road and we were moving. So we did research in these cities and we knew areas that we wanted to visit, but a lot of it was just, you know, just going out, and we were in the cities and making calls and trying to make, you know, real connections with people. Once we were actually in the cities, it was possible, because then people would, you know, tell us, oh, you got to meet this guy, and we found a lot of people that we had never heard of. We weren't just going for the big names, and
sure.
So fortunately it worked out that people were, they would help us out.
That's kind of what we do as reporters, you know. You're out there making the phone calls.
Yeah, it really wasn't just, it wasn't our comfort zone.
Sure.
It was more journalistic kind of,
yeah.
You know, cold calls.
Yeah.
Like, you have no reason to help
it's
me.
It's not easy,
but,
is it?
Yeah, no, yeah. It was interesting.
So guys, and whoever wants to answer this, you know, what do you really hope that people take from this project?
I think that, we hope that people can kind of get a little piece of the perspective that we got, and then just really understand that, like, we decided to title the project Your Song, and that's kind of a statement that says, you know, as a musician, it's essential that you kind of practice individuality. And, you know, in talking to all these different people, that was something that everybody stressed. So we're hoping that, you know, the people that will hear this music and, you know, follow along with the whole process will kind of take some of that away, kind of just, you know, be yourself, do your own thing, and really kind of just venture out there and do that.
All right. Great job, guys. I'm sure the project is going to turn out fantastic. And you're all going to be performing for us, the Dan White Sextet, at the end of the newscast. So thanks
Absolutely.
For sticking around.
Thank you.
And we'll be right back. And we're going to leave you this morning with a performance by the Dan White Sextet in studio with us today. And that'll do it for us. We thank you for watching 10TV. Jack Hanna's Into the Wild is coming up next. Have a great Sunday. Guys, take it away.